Therefore, the origin of everything is Krishna. Just like the origin of a big tree is the root. Similarly, Krishna is the Adipurusham, Govindam Adipurusham, Sarvakarana Karanam. Just like in the tree, there are trunks, branches, twigs, sub-branches, leaves, flowers, so many things. But the cause is the root. So here it is said that paritoshanam, bhagavat paritoshanam, the root must be satisfied. If you want to maintain the tree, then the root or the original cause of the tree should be satisfied. Then everything is satisfied. So, here in this material world, they are trying to be happy, but they do not know how to become happy. They are put into the ocean of nescience, maybe very expert swimmer, but simply swimming will not save you. You must know how to save. So, here it is said, yadatra kriyate karma. Everyone is doing something. Vaidiki, laukiki, va. There are two kinds of karmas. Vaidiki means according to the Vedic rituals, performance of big sacrifices, and so many other. That is called Vaidiki. And Laukiki, just like we have got good experience nowadays, there are so many activities, factories, mills, and scientific research work, so many. This is Laukiki. So, Śrīla Gosvāmī does not say that simply by Vaidiki activities, big ritualistic ceremonies, you can be happy. You can be happy even by Laukiki. Laukiki meaning this material activities. Generally people understand big factories nowadays, or agriculture or anything, there are Laukiki. For maintenance, Laukiki means for maintenance of the body. So, Narad Muni recommends that yadatra, anything you are doing, kriyate. Atra means in this material world, atra. Yadatra kriyate karma bhagavat paritoshanam. It doesn't matter that you do not understand these Vedic rituals, but you want to develop the economic position of your country by industrial enterprises, yes, that is also good. That is also good. How? Bhagavat paritoshana. If it is conducted for the satisfaction of Krishna, then it is good. So our Krishna consciousness movement does not say you stop anything. No. Whatever you have got liking, you can do. But Bhagavat Paritoshanam, by your work, you try to satisfy Krishna. This is our purpose. We do not say the negative, stop. No. And it is confirmed in the Shastras, Atapungvi Dhijasya. Generally, according to Vedic principles, there are four divisions of karma. Varnashrama, not four, eight divisions, according to varna and ashrama. Atapungvi dijasyastha varnashrama vibhava. The division of work must be there. Otherwise, the society cannot go on very nicely. If everyone is brahmana, not interested in anything material, or simply because it is after all material world, if everyone becomes brahmana, then it will not go. There must be others. Kshatriyas mean the statesman, protector, politician, diplomat, kshatriyas. And there must be vaishyas also, productive class of men. They must produce economic development. That is also required. Otherwise, how human society will go on? Not only intelligent class of men, the protector class of men, the productive class of men and the worker class of men. Suppose we are constructing this temple. If we devotees remain Hare Krishna, then who will construct this temple? Everything is required. We do not say this, stop this or stop that. No. So that's division, different division is scientifically made in the Vedic conception of life, varna-ashrama, four varnas and four ashrama. Ashrama for spiritual advancement and varnas for material advancement. We want both of them. Because our life is combination of spirit and matter. So it is not that to make the best use of a bad bargain. Suppose you have got a car, it is not very good car. It's not American car or ambassador. Thrice brakes. But you have to utilize it. Bad bargain. Similarly, somehow or other we have got this material body, we cannot neglect it. We don't say the neglect, don't care for the body. No. Why? That is the instruction of the Goswamis. Anasaktasya visnam yatharam upajanjata. Don't be attached to the bodily demands. Bodily demand means eating, sleeping, sex life and defending. These are bodily demands. So if we say that I am not this body, so I don't care for this eating, sleeping, no. That is not. It is not vairagya. This kind of renunciation is not recommended by our Krishna consciousness movement. Krishna consciousness movement, the Goswamis recommend anasaktasya visayam. You do not be attached to the demands of the body, but you utilize it for advancing in Krishna consciousness.